Agent X of barebonesmusic.com, sitting down here with Kellen and Justin of Sleeping with Sirens. You guys have your debut album just came out. It's called With Ears to See and Eyes to Hear. First of all, what's behind that that name?
The name, when I was trying to think of what we can name the record, something that kind of hit me in my mind just from growing up with my dad and stuff like that and having kind of like a religious background, I always remembered reading like and going to church and hearing like the Lord want you to have eyes to see and ears to hear. And I just thought that it was kind of interesting because it's like a different world nowadays. So I just switched it around and just basically said like, you know, you have to have ears to see and eyes to hear because everything's so different, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
And when we were writing the record, that's something that we wanted to focus on too, is just trying to do something that was original and different, not something that was the same, so.
Okay. Well, how do you guys feel about the great response that you've already gotten off your debut album?
It's crazy.
Yeah? I mean, talk about that a little bit.
We did not expect as much, I guess, publicity and as much, exposure, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
We put our album up on our MySpace. We streamed the whole thing. And by the end of the day, we had 100,000 plays. And it was just mind-blowing to us, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
we've never seen anything like that.
Yeah, you know? I mean, how do you wrap your head around something like that?
I don't know, it's crazy. And then, you know, all of our friends, you know, at home telling us, you know, we can't find your CD anywhere in stores, it's all sold out, and it's so crazy to us, like, we can't even comprehend that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's awesome, though.
Are you all seeing the same type of response from your live shows as well?
Yeah, we get a lot of people coming out and appreciating our live performance and saying, you know, that it sounds close to the CD or as close as possible, which is awesome to us because we want to be able to show people that not only we can write a good record but also perform it live on stage and give people a great show. And as far as like, I just wanted to touch back on the question you asked before about how we feel about our CD and the exposure and all that. Honestly, it's just like, when you're in the studio and you're writing a CD and you're thinking about the songs you're placing on it, you don't really know what's going to happen. It's kind of scary. And then when it gets put out there, like, that's where, you know, you get to actually see that response. And we just feel very blessed that people really like it and appreciate it. And I mean, I couldn't thank you guys enough.
Oh, absolutely.
Our friends and our fans.
Absolutely. Yeah. So. You also had a debut video of the album just come out, and that one was called If I'm James Dean, You're Audrey Hepburn.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about the concept behind that video, because I watched it today, and just kind of tell us what's behind that.
Basically, when we were talking about the video and what the song meant, it was the song's about love and basically like the struggle, the joy, and the like longing. I wrote it when I was away from my girlfriend and was just feeling kind of like the missing kind of feeling, and I wanted to write a song that just kind of let her know that like it didn't matter what happened, like, you know, whatever happened between me, the band, or anything else in life, like things happen for a reason and things will last if you put your heart into it. And so when we were talking about that with Caleb, the guy that did our video, we really wanted to stress like the whole wanting to be with someone and then, you know, so many forces and things around you like trying to stop you from getting what you want, but just continuing to just strive for it. And like, you know, the people in the hallway pulling on the guy and all that stuff, that basically just is just like life trying to stop you from getting what you want. And then him breaking that mirror and like breaking through everything is basically like him persevering and getting what he, you know, was fighting for.
So. Okay. Yeah, very cool. Now give us a typical on tour day in the life of Sleeping with Sirens. How's that day break down?
Well, a lot of sleeping. it's tiring at times.
Yeah.
We do a lot of staying up though also. We drive a lot through the night. We like to drive halfway usually, just so that we can sleep in a little bit, and then we'll get back on the road in the morning. But I don't know, like right now the rest of the guys are outside playing football.
And you're stuck in here doing an interview.
Yeah, we're stuck doing this. But it's a lot of fun. Like we all get along really well. We all, you know, have been best friends for a long time, and you know, finally met back up and are in bands together now. So it's, we all connect, and so we just have a lot of fun, a lot of goofing around, a lot of, you know, football or, you know, frisbee, whatever. And you know, loading in, we always make that fun, and loading out even. But we all hang out, you know, all day long, you know, at the merch table, wherever. We're always just trying to hang out, so.
Yeah.
It's interesting going on tour with bands that have been doing it for a while, because we're like the young guns, you know, and you've got like all these big dogs that have been doing it for a while. So we have to like somewhat stay responsible while everyone's like, you know, goofing off and having fun. But is, you know, when we do get time to have fun and goof off too, it's much appreciated, because there's a lot of work you have to do when you're starting out, so.
Yeah. Now about your live show, obviously you guys play a lot of material from your debut album, because you want the fans to hear that, and they want to hear it too. What about, I'm curious about covers. You guys cover any other bands, any other songs?
We don't yet. We're thinking about one.
What do you think about?
We can't tell.
Can't
just give us a hint?
It's going to be a secret, because if we tell everybody, then they're going to know and they're going to do it, because it's such a good cover.
Oh, it's
no
one
one's
of those.
Done it yet.
Is it like one of those that's not normally played that way?
Yeah.
And yes.
You guys put your own spin to it?
Yep. We put the Sleeping of Sirens spin on it.
Okay. Well, I'll settle for this. How about some influences? Fast. What influences your sound?
When we wrote the CD, we didn't really listen to any music. We kind of, it was more or less like, we got in there and we just wrote what came out. But, you know, we all listen to a lot of different music. I listen to underground hip hop, you know, acoustic stuff, whatever. And like Kellen in the past has done a lot of acoustic like projects and stuff like that. So it's all, you know, it's all kind of a big intertwined mess of things. And we all just kind of put our own, you know, touch on it.
That's kind of why it works. Yeah. You know?
It's different. I don't know. We didn't really listen to anything when we wrote it, so I wouldn't say it like, I mean, obviously we have influences, but when we wrote that, we didn't want to be distracted and like start writing like another band. We wanted to be ourselves.
Mm-hmm. So. We know like the industry and like the bands that are big and the bands that are successful and doing their thing, and we just didn't want that to like affect the way we wrote something, because we wanted like this project to very much be us. So.